Recently, I learned about bees and why they are essential to us and our planet. Join me today as we discover more about these sweet insects, the honeybees. I was talking to one of my good friends yesterday. He has beehives that produce honey, and it sparked my interest to learn a bit more. I have taken many photos of bees in the past. They certainly are hard to capture a great photo of, but I truly never knew how fascinating they truly are. Honeybees are a type of insect that is well known for their unique ability to pollinate plants and produce honey. Honeybees are social insects that live together in hives consisting of a queen, male drones, and female worker bees. The worker bees are responsible for various tasks, such as caring for the young, foraging for food, and building the hive. The queen bee is responsible for laying eggs, and the male drones mate with the queen to create new offspring. Let's explore each type a little bit more. Queen bees are an essential component of honeybee colonies, serving as the mother and reproductive center of the hive. They are created through a process, which I've never heard of before, called royal jelly feeding, in which the worker bees select a single larva and feed it a special diet of royal jelly, which triggers the development of the queen bee's reproductive system. The queen then hatches and begins laying eggs, which will develop into the worker bees and drones that make up the rest of the colony. In a honeybee colony, the queen bee plays a crucial role in the colony's survival and growth. She is responsible for laying the eggs that produce the various types of bees in the colony. Besides reproduction, she is responsible for signals to the other bees when it is time to swarm in search of a new home. Additionally, the queen bee releases pheromones that help maintain the cohesion and harmony of the colony. Female worker bees are an important component of a bee colony or hive. They cannot reproduce like the queen bee can. The worker bees are responsible for a wide range of tasks, such as collecting nectar, pollen, and water, cleaning and maintaining the hive, caring for the queen and her eggs, and defending the hive against predators. Worker bees are typically smaller than the queen bee, and they start their life as nurse bees, feeding and caring for the brood within the hive. As they age, they take on responsibilities such as foraging for nectar and pollen, secreting wax to build the honeycomb, and defending the hive. Unlike the female worker bees and queen bees, male drone bees do not engage in tasks such as foraging for food or caring for the young. Instead, their primary function is to mate with a queen bee from another colony. Drone bees are larger than worker bees and have distinctive physical characteristics, including big eyes and a bulky thorax. Drones die immediately after mating with the queen bee and are expelled from the colony to die. Have you ever wondered why the honeycomb is shaped the way it is? I have. Honeycomb that bees produce are typically shaped in a hexagonal pattern. This hexagonal shape of the cells is important for several reasons. First, it maximizes the use of space within the hive. The cells fit closely together without leaving gaps, which allows the hive to store more honey and raise more brood in the available space. Second, the hexagonal shape also provides strength and stability to the honeycomb structure. The walls of the cells are thin, but the hexagonal shape helps distribute weight and pressure across the entire structure, making it strong enough to support the weight of honey and bees. The process of creating honey starts with bees collecting nectar from flowering plants using their long tongues. The nectar is then stored in the bee's honey stomach, where enzymes break down the complex sugars in the nectar into simpler sugars. The bee regurgitates the partially digested nectar into the hive's honeycomb, where it is broken down further by enzymes and fanned by the bee's wings to evaporate the water content. This process results in a thick, viscous liquid we know as honey, which is then capped with beeswax and stored as a food source for the colony. Many factors, including the species of bee and the types of flowers from which the nectar is collected, can affect the color, taste, and texture of the honey produced. Honeybees alone pollinate 80% of all flowering plants, including more than 130 types of fruits and vegetables worldwide. They have a significantly positive impact on so many crops and our ecosystem that it would be extremely devastating if they were to ever become extinct. With that in mind, honeybees face numerous threats, including habitat loss, pesticides, and diseases. These threats have resulted in a significant decline in honeybee populations over the past several decades. Despite these challenges, the importance of honeybees cannot be overstated. They continue to play an essential role in agriculture and in the environment as a whole. Through their pollination activities, honeybees help to ensure the continued growth of fruits, nuts, and other food crops, and as contributors to the honey industry, they provide a valuable food source for people across the world. With everything that we talked about today, honeybees are a unique and valuable type of insect with important roles in pollination, honey production, and the wider ecosystem. As such, it is essential to work towards protecting them from the various threats they face to ensure their continued survival and contribution to human society.